Hallelujah! Oh, every good and every perfect gift. Strength of my life.
Oh, you're the strength
hallelujah.
Of my life. Oh, hallelujah.
You're the He's the light of my salvation.
Hallelujah,
glory, hallelujah,
yes.
Hallelujah,
shalom,
yes.
Thank you, Lord, for the promises of all year. Amen. Hey, the promises are sure.
Yes,
the promises are sure.
Glory to God.
I can do all things through you, Lord. That strengthens me. That strengthens me.
Yes, you, Lord.
Yeah. Thank you for the victory, Lord. This is the victory that overcomes. This is the victory that overcomes. This is the victory that overcomes. Praise God. Hallelujah.
Yes, Lord Jesus. Hallelujah. Glory to God.
All right, we want to ask everybody to stand. There's all the brothers together around. All the brothers to come. Everybody, hey, everybody come together. I'm going to pray in the Spirit for 5 minutes. Glory. I'm going to pray in the Spirit for 5 minutes. Everybody,
yes,
pray in the Spirit.
Jesus. Glory to God.
Yeah. Love, 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 love.
Glory to God.
Yeah, love, 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 love.
Yes, Lord Jesus. Glory to God. Yes, Lord Jesus.
Everybody to pray in the Spirit. Everybody to pray in the Spirit. I'm going to hear y'all. I'm going to shut up.
Thank you.
For instance, on Sunday, just like Sunday at around 11 o'clock, the Spirit of God really wanted to move. You could just kind of feel it suppressed. And that's the time everybody can lift their voices and pray out loud in the Spirit. And you'd be surprised of how people all over the place would be really, really moved by God. See, that's one of the reasons why we don't impact people when they come, because nobody will release themselves.
Right.
Everybody's quiet, depending on somebody else to get the anointing. Amen. And everybody's quiet. You can't hardly hear anybody praying in the Spirit on Sundays in this church. And it's supposed to be a Holy Ghost filled church.
Right.
And if you go to many Holy Ghost filled churches, especially the whites, I mean, you hear everybody, it sounds like a river of water flowing.
Yes.
It sounds like a big commotion. And we're behind, and we don't have no money. We're messed, we're at the bottom of the thing, and we won't pray. And that's the way God has designed for us to get rich.
Amen.
But we can't catch it because we won't release ourselves. That revelation won't come. See, the Bible says you have to pray that the eyes of your understanding will be enlightened. God has to show you how to do stuff that will cause you to prosper. He has to show you that. Amen. So we either can close the meeting down, or y'all can decide you want to open up and pray, so everybody can hear you. If I didn't pray out, I wouldn't help nobody.
That's right.
Suppose I would just come and be quiet. Everybody else would be quiet too, more than likely.
That's right.
Like Brother Curtis, I didn't even know you could pray like that in the Spirit.
Me either.
I didn't even know it. That's the shame. I mean, we hold a revival back. I mean, we've been doing this for how long? Holding a revival back. Probably two or three Sundays, everybody open up and let go. And you might start crying and weeping. You might lose control of yourself. God will work. Gifts will work. And boy, we could have revival in this place. People could be getting saved. And people just will start coming down to the altar without you even asking them to come.
That's right.
Amen. Praise God.
I know y'all hate me this morning, but
that's true. I was at the picture of the Lord, and I looked at it, and they were just playing in the spirit.
Mm-hmm.
They was all praying in the spirit. Mm-hmm. They was
singing in the spirit.
Yeah.
And we think, y'all think sometimes we, somebody singing in the spirit, y'all think we're off. Amen. So I'm just amen. You brothers could be really, really highly used of God.
Yes.
Highly used of God. That's all we have to do is open up and let God have his way. Because when you open up, it's God that's doing the work.
Amen.
And sometimes you just have to come to the point that, Lord, I don't know what to do. I don't know how to do, but I can open up and I can pray and you can take over my life.
Yes.
And whatever you want done through me, Lord, hallelujah, I'm available for you to do it.
Well, I'm ready to listen.
Yeah.
And let the Spirit rise. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord Jesus.
Now, the Lord showed me that. He showed me that if everybody would just kind of let go.
Yeah.
And, and come to the conclusion that if whatever God wants to do, I'm going to have to yield to him so he can do it through me. And I can't, he won't do it through me unless we place ourselves in a position for him to do it. If we just quiet and timid, some act like, well, I'm really timid. I'm not sure whether this will work if I open my mouth. I don't think I can do it like Pastor Gil or whatever. And if we just hold back too much on God, as long as we hold back on him, he's going to hold back on us.
That's
because
right.
His
that's
hands
right.
are tied.
That's right.
Amen. Everybody should be able to pray. Pray to the Spirit, pray it out loud where everybody can hear you. Amen. And that's how everybody can build up. I got to draw some from Brother Curtis. Draw some from Brother Sonny.
Yeah.
If everybody's holding it in, ain't nothing to draw.
That's
I don't even know what's
right.
I don't even know whether there's anything going on or not.
That's right.
Praise God. I tell you, we all need to open up and let God have his way. You'll be weeping, you'll get broken. This Bible says the sacrifices of God are a broken spirit. That's the only way God can really release himself through us, is that we got to get broken.
Yeah.
You got to get past beyond how you look and feel and what people think. And, amen, I ain't never done this before. Amen, I'm not sure whether it'll come out right. Amen, you got to get beyond all of that stuff so God can begin to use you. I just want everybody to receive all that God has for you, because when we begin to go out and deal with all of these difficult situations, amen, the more you have released yourself and the more you have prayed in the Spirit, we call that deep praying, then the more God can use you and the more God can quicken or make alive whatever you are doing. If you're singing, if you're praying, if you're teaching or preaching, God will be able to get into that big time. But the practice comes in the morning at 5 o'clock. Amen. From 5 to 6, amen, we don't come to rest.
That's right.
Amen. You can go back home and meditate for another hour. Or you can get up at 4 o'clock and meditate. Amen. But when we come here, amen, praise God, at least half of the time, we ought to be praying in the Spirit. And the other praying is not going to do that much. Yes, Lord, thank you, Jesus. Praise the Lord. That's not going to do a whole lot. The most powerful praying, praying beyond your ability, is always praying in the Spirit, singing in the Spirit. Amen. Or lifting up your voice and Shabbat. Hashab Tomo Shande Meta Tashumuhulanda De La Mahola Maka. That's how you do spiritual warfare. You come against everything that's going to interfere with your peace, your joy, your work, and your success. You're dealing with everything that's going to interfere, amen, and conflict with that real power that God has moving through you. Amen. So next week we're going to turn the table, amen, because we could do this a whole year and it won't get no, we still won't be praying in the Spirit. You know, it'll be soft and low, but that's not going to bring the breakthrough that all of us need.
Amen.
Praise God. So let me ask y'all, what do y'all want to do? Y'all just want to shut down and we can stay at home and be quiet?
Amen.
Yes. Hey, so Brother Curtis prayed out like that. I just said, pray 5 minutes. Amen. Praise God. I hear Brother Mariko. I hear most of the brothers. I wasn't sure what I was hearing, whether it was in English or whether it was in the Spirit, because it wasn't loud enough for me to detect. But that's how everybody learned how to proceed. If a few start out being bold in prayer, everybody else will catch on. All right, the reason why y'all have caught on, the little bit y'all have, is because a few of us have been bold. We pray out, and then many times, y'all will do it in spurt. You do it here, a little there.
Yeah, a little there.
Amen. So if you went into a white congregation where the gifts were working, amen, everybody in that place is praying in the Spirit. I guarantee you, praying with everybody. They can pray in tongues.
Yeah.
And they're praying out real loud.
Yeah.
It may sound like a river flowing. I mean, that's overflowing. I mean, a loud noise. It sounds like a roaring. Just a roaring. I know that it's just roaring all through the audience. A big, loud roar. Yeah. Amen. So I just want to say next week, just want to just put a little bit more in, and if I have to shut up, and everybody shut up, so everybody can.
Don't shut up, Pastor Hill.
Lower.
Just go low.
Okay. Now I was thinking that I'm going to be gone for a week, about 10 days. And I didn't know whether y'all want to shut down until I got back, wait for me to come back, or whether y'all want to go on. Okay, now I'll get some keys and then I can catch this guy. So whoever want to be a key person, you have to be here at 5.
Like this morning, I was slept. Amen. I'll get some keys, and whoever got a key, you got to be here at 5.
Right.
Can't be late. Amen. Praise God. All right. All right. So, you know, I don't mean to be hard on you, but
if we're not pushed,
we'll be doing this for the next 10 years, and we're going to be in the same condition. Amen. Nobody can win a soul because we won't release the anointing. You don't have to be no educated person to win a soul. If you let the Lord use you and flow through you, the Lord will tell you, amen, how to do and what to do.
All right, let's go. Amen.
I'm ready to go. Praise God. All right, next week. All right, we're going to, amen, we're going to go in, amen, shift in high gear.
Praise God. Hallelujah.
Get y'all fired up before I leave.
I'm going to shut up too, Pastor.
And the week that I leave, when I come back, I want to hear a good report. Man, I would like to see this place on Sunday. I'd like to see this play, man. I'd like to see us turning this. I believe a man can do it.
Yes. Amen.
I mean, this is the time for men to shine. We can turn this place out.
Yes.
I mean, we can have so many people at the altar. Amen.
Thank you, Lord.
Y'all believe I'm telling you right?
I'm ready for it.
All right.
Get the keys out.
All right, get the keys out. Brother Rico, I might give you one for Friday. I'll
give you on Monday or Friday.
Okay, all right.